Good morning, students. Today we are going to see yesterday's type example. So here in this example, if A and B are both rational numbers, find the values of A and B. Okay. So here one example is here. Root 3 minus 1 upon root 3 plus 1 equals to A plus B root 3. Means you will get after simplifying this number. Left hand side of this, you will get the number in this form, right? So from that we have to select or we have to find out what is A and what is B. Simply that is what it means. Only we have to do the rationalization of denominator and we have to solve up till final steps, okay? And then we have to compare that final number or final product or final whatever we have got here, that we have to compare with this right side, okay, and from that we have to take A and B value. That's it, okay. So here root 3 minus 1 upon root 3 plus 1, we did solve this side, right? So what is the rationalizing factor for this? Root 3 plus 1 is there, then what is the rationalizing factor? Yes, root 3 minus 1, okay. So here root 3 minus 1 upon root 3 plus 1 multiplied by b. What is the rationalizing factor? Root 3 minus 1. So we have to multiply into both the numerator and denominator. Root 3 minus 1. And here is equals to a plus b root 3. Okay. We have to compare with this. Right? Now here, what will be there? Root 3 minus 1, root 3 minus 1. So next step is what? Multiplication of numerator upon multiplication of denominator. So here, root 3 minus 1, both the numbers means both the factors are same. So we will write as it is in this form? Yes. Root 3 minus 1 will comes. It comes how many times? 2 times. So we can take it as a square. Okay? Upon here, here which identity form came? A plus B, A minus B. So what will be the A square minus B square? Okay, A square means whose square? Root 3 square minus B square means 1 square equals to here. This side we can keep as it is. Correct? Then now here which identity we will use? Root 3 minus 1. So which identity? Yes, A minus B bracket square. Correct? A minus B bracket square. So what is the A minus B bracket square identity? Yes, A square minus 2AB minus sign. So we have to give here minus and when plus sign is there, simply all terms are positive. Correct? So plus second term square is what? B square. So same form we have to use here. Right? So A square means whose square? Root 3 square minus 2AB means 2A and this is your B. So 2 into root 3 into 1. Okay? Plus B square means whose square here? 1 square. Okay? Upon here root 3 square is what? 3. Minus 1 square is what? 1. Equals to A plus B root 3. Correct? Now here, what is root 3 square? 3. Root 3 square is 3. Minus, here multiplication of this all number, 2 multiplied by 1, that is 2. And multiplied by root 3 is 2 root 3. Correct? So you will get 2 root 3 plus what is 1 square? 1 square is 1. Right? Upon here 3 minus 1 is your 2 equals to A plus B root 3. Okay. Now here this 3 and this 1, these are the simple numbers. Okay. So 3 plus 1, 4. 4 minus 2 root 3 upon 2 equals to A plus B root 3. Now, we cannot do here 4 minus 2 root 3. Then and these two with the irrational number. So we cannot these four do the subtraction. So we can take what is the common in both? Here 4 and here 2. So 4 is the multiple of 2. So we can take that 2 is common, correct? So 2 inside, then 2 2's are 4. Minus 2 is already out. So what is remaining? Root 3. Correct? And upon 2 equals to a plus b root 3. Now this 2 2 will get cancelled. So what is remaining? 2 minus root 3 equals to a plus b root 3. Now how we will write this number? See, 2, which sign is here? Plus, and here what is? Not there any number means what? 1. So simply here minus 1 root 3 equals to a plus b root 3. Okay. So here what is your a? A is your 2. And plus sign, so a plus, and what is your b? B is minus 1. Okay. From that here, from these steps also we can do this same. A is 2 and what is b? B is not there any number, means root 3 is there, root 3 is there, right? So where is b present? B is present here only. B is present here. So here not any single number, means always which number is present? There is a 1. So but how that 1 will come? Minus 1. Understood? So you can do either from this directly or we can express like this number, right? So here a equals to 2 and b equals to minus 1. Understood everyone? In this way we have to find the values of a and b. Or in this example, you can separately solve this left hand side, and when you will get final number, then at the final step you can compare this number with what we want, a plus b root 3 and so on. Understood? So in this way we have to find the values of a and b. Now we will see one more example. Next example, 5 plus 2 root 3 upon 7 plus 4 root 3. Okay, now we will solve this example. So here 5 plus 2 root 3 upon 7 plus 4 root 3. Then rationalize this by which factor? 7 minus 4 root 3 upon 7 minus 4 root 3. Okay, we are simply in this example we will simplify this side and then last we will compare with this. Okay, so here multiplication of numerator upon multiplication of denominator, correct? So you will get here 5 plus 2 root 3 and second bracket 7 minus 4 root 3 upon here 7 plus 4 root 3 and 7 minus 4 root 3. Okay. Then same, we have to make the multiplication of both this bracket, right? So 5 in bracket means from this number, by this, from this number we have to multiply this whole bracket. So 5 into 7 minus 4 root 3. Correct? Then we sign it here plus. So there is no need to keep the bracket here, correct? Then from this number 2 root 3 in bracket 7 minus 4 root 3. Understood everyone this day? Okay. Then next, here which identity? Yes. A plus B, A minus B. So what will be there? A square minus B square. A square means whose square? 7 square minus b square means whose square? 4 root 3 bracket square. Correct? So next, now we have to make the multiplication of this. Correct? So 7, 5, 7 are, now I will write directly, 5, 7 are 35. Okay? Minus. Then what will be there? 5 into 4 root 3. Then here we have to multiply this 5 to the 4. 5 for the 20. And this root 3 remains as it is. So you will get 20 root 3. Right? again from this number we have to multiply to inside number. Okay, so 2 multiplied by 7, 7 to the 14 root 3. Okay, so plus or minus, plus 2, 7 to the 14 and this root 3. So 14 root 3, like this we have to write. Then we sign plus minus, minus, plus minus, minus. Okay, then here multiplication of these two numbers, multiplication of these two numbers. Okay, so 2 root 3 and 4 root 3, see here, 2 root 3 multiplied by 4 root 3. Now 2 and 4, 2 fours are 8, 2 fours are 8, and there is a bigger multiplication sign, correct? And root 3 into root 3, where two numbers are in a square sign, then multiplication is number itself, so it is 3. Okay, so 8 threes are 24. Okay, next step we will do diagram. 2 fours are 8 and root 3 into root 3, 3. So 8 threes are 24. Understood? So here we will take it is 24 upon here 7 square is 49 minus, then what is the square of 4? 4 square is 16. Multiply by what is the square of root 3? That is 3. So 16 threes are 48. 16 threes are 48. Okay. Now next step here 35 minus 24. These are the whole numbers, correct? 35 minus 24. So how many 35 minus 24? 5 minus 4, 1 and 3 minus 2, 1. Okay. So you will get here 11. Right? Then here see 20 root 3 and 14 root 3. Do you remember? Means when we have learned that operations of a number, in that what we are doing? Collecting the like terms together and unlike terms together, right? So you know that the like terms. So is there, are this such a type? These are like terms. Okay, means root 3 is here also and root 3 is here also. So we can add or we can subtract. Okay. So here one number is negative and one number is positive. So when one number is negative, one number is positive, what we are doing? We are subtracting and giving the bigger number sign. Okay. So simply this we have to subtract 20 and 14. We don't have to subtract root 3 and root 3. Right? See that this cannot cancel. Root 3 minus root 3, that is, means here in this case, root 3 minus root 3, that means you will get 0. Not at all. Okay? So here this root 3 remains as it is. Then 20 and 14, in that we can do the subtraction. 20 and 14, right? So one number is negative, one number is positive. So do the subtraction. 14 and 20 and 14. So 20 minus 14, how many remaining? 6. But what is the bigger number sign? Negative. So you will get minus 6. Correct? Minus 6 root 3. Minus 6 root 3 upon here. 49 minus 48, you will get 1. Okay. Now you got this number 11 minus 6 root 3. This final product you got. This final answer you got. Now you have to compare with this right side. Correct? So here, what is your right side? A plus B root 3. Okay. So can we write this directly? What is A? A is your 11. Right? And what is B? Here negative sign is there and here positive sign. So here how the B is there? B negative. Root 3 is root 3 is there, right? So what is the B? Minus 6. Correct? Understood everyone? Now again we will see next example only. We will see now the next type of example. Type of example is the same type examples. In that only we don't have to find the values of A and B. Okay, so we in previous example we have learned that how to find the values of A and B. Suppose that it is given into the A plus B form or A minus B form, is right side. It minus sign is there, according to that sign we have to make the changes. Okay, so now we will see only the simplify things. What you will get? You will get finally the values, right? So you simply it is evaluate. Okay, so simplify that what? See here, this fraction and this fraction form means numerator denominator, here also numerator denominator means like this. Before that we have learned only one type this it is given, and then to rationalize the denominator also we have learned there how to find the values of a and b, means what you will get the final number that we have to compare with the a and b values. Now here both the numbers are there with which form? Addition form. Okay, so first we will simplify this individually, then afterwards we will simplify this individually, and then what you will get the final number that we will add. Okay, see here, so 4 plus root 5 upon 4 minus root 5. We can do at the same time with this addition or subtraction at the same time rationalize the denominator, correct? But we can simply solve one by one. Okay, so it is easy for you. Then here multiply by this. What is the rationalizing factor for this? I am taking only this term. Okay, so what is the rationalizing term factor for this? 4 plus root 5, and here 4 plus root 5. Okay, so you will get this 4 plus root 5, 4 plus root 5. So 4 plus root 5 bracket square upon here a minus b, a plus b. So you will get a square means what? 4 square minus b square means what? Root 5 square. Understood? Here which identity we will use? A plus b. A plus b bracket square identity we will use. So what is the expansion of a plus b bracket square identity? A square plus 2ab plus b square. So according to that, what will be the 4 square plus 2ab means 2 into what is your a? A is 4 into b is what? Root 5. Correct? Plus b square. B square means 2 square root 5 square. Right? Afterwards, upon here a square minus b square identity. What is the factor? Means what is the expansion? A plus b, a minus b. A square minus b square. So what you will get? A square minus b square means 4 square is what? 16 minus root 5 square is 5. Correct? Now here 4 square is 16, then plus 4 to the a, here this root 5 plus what is the root 5 square? It is 5 upon 16 minus 5, you will get 11. Okay. So finally you will get for this 16 plus 5, it is 21, correct? So 21 plus 8 root 5 upon 11. Okay, now we will solve this. Next, 4 minus root 5 upon 4 plus root 5. Okay, so what is the rationalizing factor for this? 4 minus root 5. Okay, so 4 minus root 5 upon here 4 minus root 5. Okay, so here what you will get? Here a minus b means 4 minus root 5 bracket square, correct? So divided by a plus b, a minus b. So what will be there? A square minus b square. So 4 square minus root 5 bracket square, correct? Now here we will expand this, which by identity a minus b bracket square identity. So what a minus b bracket square identity? A square means 4 square. 4 square minus 2 into a is what? 4 into b is what? Root 5. Okay, 2ab, right? Plus b square means 4 square? Root 5 square. right? Divided by 4 square is what? 16 and minus root 5 square is 5. So you will get 4 square is 16 minus 4 to the 8 root 5 plus root 5 square is 5 upon 16 minus 5, 11. So you will get here 16 plus 5. Now what? 21 minus 8 root 5 upon 11. Now these and these two that we got individually, we have solved this. So you got for this expression this simplified form, right? And for this you got this simplified form. Now what we have to do? Addition, correct? So now we can add this both. Means here I will write this again. 4 plus root 5 upon 4 minus root 5 plus here 4 minus root 5 upon 4 plus root 5. So what do you got for this? We got this 21 plus 8 root 5 upon 11 plus, for this what we got? 21 minus 8 root 5. Okay, so 21 minus 8 root 5 upon 11. Now everyone know that in the denominator absent we have to add or subtract, correct? So here 21 plus 8 root 5 plus 21 minus 8 root 5 upon 11. Now this plus 8 root 5 minus 8 root 5 get cancelled because these are the like terms and with the opposite sign. So I am 21 plus 21, how many? 42 upon 11. So this is your simplified answer of this example. Understood everyone?